Alright guys, Fula coming to you with another video. Shout out to the whole LDBC. If you like this video, I invite you to up-like the video. And also, if you want more content from this page, and you want to be in the loop with what we got going on in this page, I invite you to subscribe, okay? And just keep, I'll keep y'all posted on what's going on, like what kind of things we got going on the page. You know, I'm hoping that, you know, we got some big stuff coming. You know, I don't want to speak too soon, but, you know, we're gonna make it do what it do. So, you know, let's get back to some boxing. You know, I know I've been on the social tip kind of often on these videos, but let's get back to some boxing, man. So, you know, I didn't want to really give this clown the time of the day, but, you know, with me, I can usually sense when a guy's, like, built for the truck or when the guy's just, like, really built for taxi cabs. And Terence Crawford is built for taxi cabs, and that's just the reality. You know, it's not what you say, it's what you do that really lets me know what type of person you are and how, and like how your mentality, and when it comes to boxing, when it comes to just life in general, you know. So Terence Crawford is basically, you know, I'm just going to call it what it is, and people aren't going to like it. Terence Crawford is a duck, you know, and that's just the bottom line. Terence Crawford is an opportunist, and that's just the bottom line. Terence Crawford is desperate for one single fight, and that's just the bottom line. Much in the same vein as Gennady Golovkin and his desire to fight Canelo for a third time. You know, it's the same thing. It's not any different, because this is the thing. Like, Gennady Golovkin has been very inactive, has been very quiet, and instead of for example taking another fight or unifying those belts or something like that, he's basically waiting on what Canelo is going to do. And that's the same thing with Terence Crawford. You know, Terence Crawford is just basically waiting on what Errol Spence is going to do. You know, and the crazy thing about the whole situation about it is that, you know, I'm not saying this like in a negative way, but Errol Spence, you know, He is indeed back in the gym training. He is indeed, like, getting his feet, you know, getting his feet wet back into the boxing after the accident. We all know that he had that very, very, very unfortunate accident, you know. And they're still trying to, like, scrutinize him and put dirt on his name because of that accident. You know, now they're talking about that they found a blower on him, you know. And so it's like, okay, well, you know, you're a high-profile dude. Like, you got to protect yourself, you know. And unfortunately, people don't want to see you win. Not everybody want to see you win. So, of course, you're going to keep a blower on you, you know. Because, of course, it would be nice that you have a bodyguard on duty all the time. But you're not going to always have a bodyguard, you know. So that's just it. But the thing is about Terence Crawford is that, you know, there's dudes who want to fight him. There's dudes who are willing to fight him. Sean Porter is one of the dudes who's willing to fight him. Danny Garcia has been willing to fight Terence Crawford for the right amount of money. You can't just lowball him and give him what he's been getting paid for at PBC for lesser fights. You can't just give him the same amount when he's already making that for fighting lesser dudes at the PBC. Another guy that Terence Crawford never mentions, who I feel would probably beat him. Like, I mean, people are saying, oh, well, you know, he's nobody. He's not an elite welterweight and stuff like that. But, you know, I mean, Terence Crawford has not fought anybody on the level of Yordanis Ugas. And I have a feeling that Yordanis Ugas will be countering him all night long. You know? Like, they like, Top Rank and ESPN want to, like, hype up Terence Crawford as this some kind of, like, mythical figure that you know, everybody should bow down to and everybody that everybody needs. And the reality is, it's the opposite. It's the opposite. He needs PBC fighters. But he paints this narrative that they need him. And they really don't. Because they have already fights among each other that can be made that would be very, very good fights. Like, people, at this point, people would rather see a rematch with Sean Porter and Errol Spence rather than Errol Spence and Terence Crawford, because the first fight was so close. The first fight was exciting. The first fight was a shootout, okay? The first fight was rough and tough. People want to see that. So that's what I'm saying, like, but, like, you know, and so it's just, like, stupid to me, like, that this fool Bud is just holding his breath for an Errol Spence fight. It's like, man, you're, like, so, it's like he's obsessed with him or something, man. Like, it's like, it's like, you know, it's like a little high school crush. You write a little letter to them, and then you're just waiting for the response, waiting, and you just keep on bugging them about, like, will you go out with me? Please check yes or no. And then the person that you're in pursuit of is just, like, going on with their lives, living their life and stuff like that. You know, the thing is, I don't know how in shape Errol Spence is. I don't know what his condition is in training. You know, I don't know how much percentage Errol Spence is. Errol Spence has said that he doesn't want to take a tune-up. He said that just put me in the line of fire again, you know, put me with all the smoke and stuff like that. But at the same time, it's like, okay, well, you know, I get it, you know, and that's something to be admired. But at the same time, it's like, when you look at Terence Crawford, it's like, I mean, it's like you want an Errol Spence fight so badly, because I'm pretty sure you're thinking along the lines that, oh, you know, like, since he's coming back, you know, he's not going to be the same fighter anymore because of the accident. That's probably what he's thinking, you know? And it's like, man, you really need to chill out. And then here's another thing that these Terence Crawford fanboys really don't want to address or acknowledge. They say, you know, Terence Crawford has said that I don't want to fight Sean Porter because he's a friend. Listen, man, Errol Spence and Sean Porter were friends. Errol Spence's father, Sean Porter's father, Kenny Porter, helped train Errol Spence for the Olympics, okay? I believe they sparred together before, too. Okay? That didn't stop them from fighting. Lamont Peterson was Errol Spence's friend. That didn't stop them from fighting, though. They still fought. So, if he's willing to fight them, and they're quote-unquote friends, then Terence Crawford, there's no excuses for him, bro. None at all. There's really no excuses. This is a fight game. Y'all be friends afterward. Now, I can see, look, I can see if, like, the fighters had the same trainers, okay? I get it. If the fighters had the same trainers, then I can understand that. Like, you know, like, and they happen to be in the same division, but they have the same trainers, then I get it. I'm like, okay, I get that. You know what I mean? I get it. But if fighters don't have the same trainers, but they're friends, and there's some things at stake, like some money at stake, some big money at stake, like, it doesn't just have to be a belt at stake. Sometimes it can just be money at stake. And if money is at stake, big money, if it's a fight that's gonna sell, if it's a fight that people want to really tap into, and it's gonna generate big purses for both fighters, sometimes belts go out the window, bro. And if you can get a big amount of money to like set up your family, then take the fight. You know, so that's what I'm saying, man. Terence Crawford is a joke at this point in time. And I've always thought Terence Crawford was a joke, okay? Whatchamacallit? Timothy Bradley is an even bigger joke than Terence Crawford, okay? You know, a lot of those top-ranked fighters are jokes, bro. Bob Arum is a freaking joke when it comes to making fights, bro. Like, I mean, honestly, like, Top Rank is a joke promotional company, you know, and I'm just going to say it like this, that, you know, like, if I were like these fighters, if I were these fighters who were on Top Rank, I would try to freeze out Bob Arum. I would, like, really try to freeze that fool out. I would take it. Listen, man, if I was a fighter on Top Rank, I would take it upon myself to get some investors together and stuff like that to freeze out Bob Arum on God. Because he's just, like, he's a snake. You know? He really is. And it's like, man, why would I want to be promoted by this clown? I would be like, get the F out of here. You know, you're a clown, bro. It's like, you're a clown. You show your true colors most of the time. And it's like, bro, man, I'm not letting you control my career, bro. On God. Like, you're not about to dictate my career. I'm about to dictate my own career on my terms. And I'm also about to freeze you out of my career and other fighters' careers who you pretty much just screw over anyway. You know? That would be my mentality in that thing. And I hope they're listening. I hope Terence Crawford listens to this video. I hope Team Crawford listens to this video. And I also hope that Bob Arum and Timothy Bradley listens to this video. Because I have no filters when it comes to how they move. And as a matter of fact, I'll say this all in their face. You know, I probably am going to be at the Demetrius Andrade fight at on January 31st. It's weird. It's taking place on the Thursday, but you know Eddie Hearn and his tactics. But yeah, I'm dead serious, bro. If they're there, I'm gonna pull up on them and tell them about themselves, man. But anyhow, man, that's all I got from now. Leave your comments and leave your thoughts about Terence Crawford and his cowardly ways. And I'm going to tell you another thing, too. If you're a Terence Crawford fanboy and you talk slick on here, all I'm going to do is just delete your comment. You know, if it makes no sense, if there's no logic or no receipts backing your comment, you know, I don't mind a comment that's objective, you know, that's going against me. I don't mind a comment that disagrees with what I'm trying to say. But, you know, if your comment makes no sense and I just see fanboyism in your comment, then I'm going to just delete it, bro. Like, I'm not about to go back and forth with you guys. You know? Yeah, I'm Team Spence. You're darn right, I'm Team Spence. Yeah, he was messed up for doing what he did in the car accident. And that, you know, it was cause and effect for his irresponsibility. I understand that, but at the end of the day, we all know what time it is. We all know who wants to fight everybody and clean out that division. And it definitely ain't Bud Crawford. All right? Because sometimes you have to take non-title fights to get to title fights. sometimes you do have to take the stairs up, okay? But anyhow, man, that's all I got for now. Leave your thoughts. Who was signing out? Enjoy.